Good evening, and welcome to the first of our Holy Week Devotionals for 2020. Thank you for joining me this evening as we take some time out of the normality of our days to reflect on God's Word and to learn from it what it means to know Christ more and to live for Him as we approach the wonderful celebration of Easter Day. As we begin our time together, let's listen to the words of this modern song that we've been learning together, Ancient of Days. Our theme for this series of Holy Week Devotionals is Behold the Lamb of God. Each evening this week, we will be exploring what this term means for the people of God, both in the Old Testament and for us today as we live in this 21st century. I hope that these devotions will bring encouragement and thoughts on what it means to celebrate the great joy of Easter Sunday, while understanding the golden thread weaved throughout all of Scripture of God's plan of salvation. When we consider, behold the Lamb of God, we will consider it in these ways. First, a lamb for one man. Secondly, a lamb for a family. And thirdly, a lamb for the nation. Finally, a lamb for the whole world. Thinking of what it means for each and every one of us. So we turn to the Bible for our first reading this week, which comes from Genesis chapter 22. This is the story of Abraham and his son Isaac. After these things, God tested Abraham and said to him, Abraham. And he said, Here I am. He said, Take your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains of which I shall tell you. So Abraham rose early in the morning, saddled his donkey, and took two of his young men with him and his son Isaac. And he cut the wood for the burnt offering and arose and went to the place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place from afar. Then Abraham said to his young men, Stay here with the donkey. I and the boy will go over there and worship and come again to you. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on Isaac his son. And he took in his hand the fire and the knife. So they went both of them together. And Isaac said to his father Abraham, My father. And he said, Here I am, my son. He said, Behold, the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? Abraham said, God will provide for himself the lamb for a burnt offering, my son. So they went, both of them, together. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built the altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac his son and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. Then Abraham reached out his hand and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here I am. He said, Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, seeing you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him was a ram caught in a thicket by his horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called the name of that place, The Lord will provide. As it is said to this day, on the mount of the Lord it shall be provided. Amen. We each have our telltale signs of spring. We all look out for different things that tell us that spring is coming. It might be the first sight of daffodils or the smell of the first cut of grass. It might be the sounds of the lambs in the fields and the feeling of the warmth in the air. For gardeners, spring comes as seeds are bought, sown, and we see the first green shoots coming up and our hopes of a good growing season are strengthened. Gardening is a test. It's a test to see if you have got the right soil, the correct seed mix, and the balanced climate of both heat and moisture so that the seeds will germinate, produce green shoots, and grow into the plant that they're supposed to. in many ways, this is much like the story of Abraham. Throughout his life, Abraham was tested to see if he would be confident of the promises God gave him. One of those promises was that he would be made into a great nation. At the start of his story in Genesis 12, this would be laughable because the biblical text tells us that Sarah, his wife, was barren. But God was true to his word, and Sarah gave birth to their son, Isaac. Genesis 22 is a new test for Abraham. God told Abraham to take Isaac, his only son, to a place where Abraham could offer his son to God as a sacrifice. Such a test for Abraham. Having waited so long for God's promise to be fulfilled, he was now being asked to sacrifice Isaac. As with other parts of his story, Abraham believes in God and does what God has asked. Knowing what he would have to do, he makes the preparations and he pushes on to the land of Moriah, even with Isaac asking where the lamb would come from for the sacrifice. No lamb comes, and instead of a lamb on the altar, Isaac is placed on top of the wood. Just as Abraham takes his knife to sacrifice his son, the angel of the Lord calls to him to stop. The message from God is that he has passed the test. Abraham has proved that he fears God and won't withhold anything from him. He is then pointed to a ram caught in the thicket as provision for the sacrifice. So Abraham lifts down his son from the altar and places the ram on it. The ram is offered up as a burnt offering instead of his son. A lamb for one man. Although on first reading it may seem a very heartless thing for God to ask, that's not what God is doing in this story. God is doing two things. First of all, God is testing and proving that Abraham is a true man of faith. God wasn't surprised by Abraham doing what he had asked. In this grand story of this man of faith, God time and again proves that Abraham's faith is well placed in the God who has promised so much to him. And secondly, we get a glimpse of what God will do for us. In many ways, this account in Genesis 22 is a foreshadow of the events of Holy Week. A sacrifice has to be made, and it is the one and only Son of God who is offered up as the once-for-all sacrifice. In John's Gospel, we read of the loving nature of God. The loving nature that called Abraham to a life of faith, and the loving nature that calls us today. In John 3, verses 16 to 17, we read these words of Jesus. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. God gave his one and only Son as a sacrifice for us, for you, and for me. Jesus came into the world as the answer to a sin-filled world. He didn't come simply for us to enjoy him, but he came to give us freedom from sin that we may enjoy eternal life. In the story of Abraham, a lamb was provided for the one. In the story of salvation, the one and only Son of God has been provided for you. Do you know Christ as your Saviour? Are you trusting in him to save you from sin and a sin-filled world? Are you living for Christ each and every day by placing your trust in him that he will meet all your needs? Christ receives one and all. Come to him and know his goodness and his grace. Let us pray. Our Father God, we thank you for this, your word. We thank you for the story of Abraham that shows us that Abraham was right and proved right to place his trust in you. May we be proved right also by placing our trust in Christ, knowing that no one else can save us and nothing else can save us. May we enjoy the goodness of salvation as we continue to place our trust in Christ and to seek and serve him. And for hearts that do not know Christ, may they be opened to the reality of this, your word, and this, your great gospel message, so that each and every one of us may be transformed more and more into the likeness of Christ. And it's in his name we pray. Amen. As we finish our time together this evening, let's listen to the words of the modern hymn, "He Will Hold Me Fast."
Those he saves are his delight. Christ will hold me fast, precious in his holy sight. He will hold me fast. He'll not let my soul be lost. His promises shall last. But by him and so justice has been satisfied. He will hold me fast. Raised with him to endless life. He will hold me fast. Till thy faith is turned to sight. He will hold me fast.
Thank you for your company this evening on this, our first Holy Week devotional. May you know God's goodness and blessing as you continue through this week to learn what it means to truly celebrate Easter Day. May God's grace, love, and peace be with you this night and forevermore. Amen.